Amen. We just thank God for His grace today. He's such a merciful God. He's a compassionate Lord. Amen. I'm asking Brother Clark to give us a quick scripture reading, and we're going to go ahead and get started. You know, we just thank God because of His loving kindness and definite life. Therefore, our lips will praise Him. Amen. Please stand for the reading of the Word of God.
Amen. Turn your Bibles to Romans chapter 6, verse 1 through 2. When you get it, please say amen. Amen. And the word of the Lord reads as follows. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? Amen. May the Lord have a blessing to the doers and hearers of His word. Back to the hands of the pulpit. Amen.
Amen. We just thank God today. God started dealing with me yesterday. I was into the Word of God, meditating in the Word of God. And as I'm meditating in the Word of God, God sometimes is just giving me messages, plural, not one. He gives me messages when I meditate in the Word of God. And as I was meditating in the Word of God, God gave me a word talking about loving the Lord with all thine heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might. God, we ask that you bless it in Christ's name. Have your way today. God, I thank God for Lick Lady Jones today. Thank God for those that have a call of God today. And we're dealing with this thing. God, right now we bind the spirit of swamp that fall upon the men. We got to call it out. I'm calling it out. It's a spirit of swamp that'll get upon the men to make them want to go to sleep in the house of God. It's a trick of the devil. God, rebuke it right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And we stand against it. Right now, and we plead the blood of Jesus right now, against it right now, in the name of Jesus. Dealing with loving the Lord thy God with all our heart, and with all our soul, and with all our might. You got to love the Lord. Coming to church is good, but you got to have a love relationship with Jesus Christ, the Lord God Almighty. Amen. Let's go to the Word of God today. Deuteronomy chapter number 6, and verse number 4 through 9. Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse number 4 through 9. Whenever you get that, please say amen. Amen. Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse number 4 through 9. Got to have a love affair with the Lord today. See, the Word of God is so plain, but it's also serious because sometimes we put things before God. Has anybody ever put their job before God? Yes, I have. Has anybody ever put their spouse, their children before God? See, we have a tendency to put things and people and situations before God. You'll put it before God. Amen. Amen. Let's go to the Word. Deuteronomy 6 and verse number 4. Are we there yet? Amen. Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 4 says, Hear, O Israel, the Lord thy God is what? Is one Lord. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might. So what? Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy might. And these words shall I command thee this day shall he be in thy heart. And thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children, that they shall walk in them when thou sittest in thy house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. And thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thine head, and shall be a frontlet before thine eyes. And thou shalt write them upon the heart, the post of thy house, and on thy gate. And it shall be when the Lord thy God shall have brought thee into the land which he has sworn unto thy father, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, to give them great and goodly houses which thou buildest not, and houses full of all good things which thou buildest not, and well did which thou diggest not, and vineyard which thou plantest not, when thou shalt have eaten and be full. Beware, lest thou forget the Lord, which hath brought thee up out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage. So in other words, God is telling you, you got to put God first. God is more important than anything in your life. Amen. I have dared short patience for people that want to put God on the back burner. I don't have time for you. If I see that you're playing games with God, I don't make no time for you. Because life is too short. And I understand a long time ago that I must put God first. If Pastor Jones got to put God first, you got to learn how to put God first yourself. Amen. This is something I can't teach you. You're supposed to do this. Amen. Deuteronomy chapter number 3 and 13. Verse number 6 through 15. Deuteronomy chapter number 3, 13, verse number 6 through 15. There's a lot of reading today, but I want this to get down because some things you can't scream and holler. You need to teach it. This has got to be taught. Deuteronomy 13 and verse 6. If thy brother, the son of thy mother, or thy son, or thy daughter, or thy wife, or thy bosom, or thy friend, which is as thine own soul, entice thee secretly, saying, let us go and serve other gods, which thou hast not known, thou nor thy father's name, the gods of the people which are round about you, nigh unto thee, are far from thee, or from one end of the earth, even unto the other end of the earth. Thou shalt not consent unto him, nor hearken unto him, neither shall I pity him, neither shall I what? Thou spare, neither shall I conceal him, but thou shalt surely kill. My Lord, kill him. Yes, sir. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We ain't up on the Old Testament. Thank you, Lord. You try to lead somebody astray up on the Old Testament, it will cost you your life. You try to pull them away from the living God. You try to pull them away from the planets that way, the right God. Thank God, even by the Old Testament. Amen. Ain't nobody got a stone about this, amen? Amen? But God has not changed. God looked at that thing as being very important. Putting anything before God, that's what I believe. I honestly believe. Anything that you put before God, you have to suck to. Anything you put your husband before God, you suck to wind up in divorce. You put your wife before God, something to wind up in the voice. You put them children before God, they'll wind up cussing you to the face sometimes. You put anything before God, you gonna find out that it ain't worth nothing. Amen. Amen. Thou shalt not consent unto him, but thou shalt surely kill him. Thy hand shall be first upon him to put him to death, and afterwards to the land, afterwards to the hand of all the people. And thou shalt stone him with stone, and he died. Because he had what? Sought to thrust thee away from the Lord thy God, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. My Lord. So we think this is a small thing when I put people before God. Pastor, that's my wife. I got to put up before God. Right? Who's that wife? Pastor, that's my son. I can't pay my tithes because I gotta do this for my son and my daughter. You wind up losing them. Some of them wind up cussing you to your face. Because you put them before God. And thank you, Jesus, we ain't gotta be stoned. But you think God is gonna show favor on you? Anything that you pray before God, that night job that you got? Oh my goodness. Something to lose. House, cars, and all this. Our account with wealth accounts, CD accounts, and all this other stuff. You place that stuff before God. God is something to blow upon it and it's gone just like that. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. This ain't one of those sharpness because I want you to understand when you leave here today, don't place any thing or anybody before God. I'm going to say it real slow. Don't place anything or anybody before God. Sister Jones, you going north? God say go south. I got to go south. See, you wouldn't want to be. I got to go. And I